Hello, my name is Charles Ostdiek, and I have some concerns about the refueling process also, and specifically the safety of the workers during the refueling process, working with the radioactive materials. And this is because I've recently read an account in the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists about the general workforce involved in refueling nuclear power stations since the 70s and 80s in Japan and France. And generally, I was wondering, are the refueling workers at the station subcontractors? Are there measures in place for ensuring that they're not exposed over the allowable limits such that they are to radioactivity? Are they tracked over time? Because the report generally said that they tended to be migratory workers and they're not tracked over time. There's no aggregate dose accounting for each of the, for an individual worker, and there's no occupational hazard or injury reporting going on. There seems to be disincentive with maintaining dosimeters and things like that. I'm just concerned whether these sorts of processes or oversight for these processes for the safety of the workers are in place for this station and also for Nebraska's other station. I remember in April during a refueling, maybe last spring, a refueling process at the other nuclear station here where three workers were exposed accidentally to radiation because they were taking the core out of the wrong end, the fuel rods out of the wrong end of the core. And then there was a report from Fort Calhoun in June of a on-site worker accidentally punctured the apple burner. And I'm wondering whether these workers are adequately trained, or are they migrant workers, are they highly skilled, sort of, are they being taken care of over time? And if you could speak to that issue, that'd be, that's my question.
Yeah, all the red workers during the refueling are monitored for the amount of radiation that they receive while they're at the site. When they go from one site to another, all that dose is reported to the next facility, and then the facility will monitor them under their programs to assure that the annual limits are not exceeded. And David, I didn't know if you want to add to what Fort Calhoun does specifically for your contract workforce at country.
Well, in terms of our folks that actually do our refueling, we do use supplemental personnel. It's a mixed crew. We have O.P.P.D. oversight of those crews. As Mr. Pruitt has indicated, those workers, their dose is monitored very closely. They each receive radiation worker training. They have radiation protection technicians that monitor the work and oversee their work. So it's very closely controlled from start to finish. You also mentioned the unfortunate aqua dam that we had that had failed. What happened was a worker had driven too close with a piece of equipment next to it and disgraced it. Worker was trained, but the idea is just got too close to the, and we didn't have much experience with this, with these dams. What we did after that as a corrective action is we put a basically an exclusion zone. You couldn't go within to keep people away from them.